It's a bird! It's a plane! No, wait, those aren't anywhere near as restricted. We're talking about drones. Welcome to DIY in 5. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and today we'll teach you what you need to know before dropping a paycheck on that fancy flying 4K camera. While drones can give you some really cool footage, they can also do some damage if you're not careful. All the rules and regulations we mention in this video are for the US, but many other countries also have rules about what you can and can't do with that new drone. When we think of consumer drones, what most of us are thinking of is called a quadcopter. The Phantom by DJI is one of the most well-known quadcopters and will run you between $300 and $1,500, depending on options and specs. There are also toy drones, which are relatively inexpensive, smaller, and don't have the long battery life or HD camera that the higher-end drones have. Some toy models do come with a camera, so you can practice those aerial photography skills before shelling out the big money on the drone with more features. You might have also heard of racing drones, but for the purposes of this video, we'll stick to the camera-centric consumer drones. Once you've decided on a drone, your fanciful flight does not start right away. You might have to register it. That's right, all drones from half a pound to 55 pounds need to be registered. But don't worry, it should only cost you $5 and you can do it online. If you were thinking about getting a drone for your business to do some real estate photography, land surveys, or anything like that, you'll need to go one step farther and register as a pilot. We'll add links to learn more about all the different FAA rules below. Once you've charged your new drone and registered that new device, it is time to fly. Of course, there are some things to keep in mind. First things first, don't fly over people. Sometimes things happen and your drone might come down unexpectedly, so make sure you're a safe distance away. You also can't fly within 5 miles of an airport or above 400 feet. Think Hot Wheels versus Monster Truck, and it's easy to figure out why that is. There's also some other local restricted zones for flying that would take way too long to mention here, but the good news is the FAA has created an app to help you know where you can fly safely. It uses GPS to let you know what areas around you are safe, and we'll add a link to the Before You Fly app below. We've also talked to quite a few droners out there, and there's one thing they all say. At some point, your drone will crash. So don't be discouraged when it happens, just be prepared. Make sure to tighten your props and check the batteries before you fly. Don't fly in high winds, and enjoy all that great drone footage that you're about to capture. So fly high, my friends, but not too high, and venture into worlds unknown, but approved by the FAA. If you found the information in this video useful, please give it a like and make sure to check out these other DIY videos before you go. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and I'll see you next time. Have fun flying.